I thought that I should have some way of showing people what was happening, because you try and describe it and it's not. And so I asked Cap Weston if he had any time-lapse machinery, and he said, oh yes, he does have one, it's in his basement or something. And it was the damnedest thing you've ever seen, because it was these huge brass wheels, very, very heavy. And they rotated an aperture in a box, which was just, I tell you, you've seen these boxes. You've seen pictures of old Keystone Cops with a man cranking. Well, that was the box. And only it was not man cranking, it was this gearbox that connected with it. It had 8 speeds. And it was made such vibration that you had to put it on a separate table from the optics so that it didn't actually touch and jiggle one another. And I did all sorts of fiddle things, which are not important except if you're trying to repeat it. And just let it go, and it was just wonderful. I couldn't believe it. And I did have some very good professional help from a Labradorean photographer, Frank White, who helped me with the developing and all the sort of photography end of it. But in any event, that film, I often thought was the real reason I graduated. I don't think people really cared what I wrote about it. Because everybody likes the film.
What would we see? If we watch the films, what do they show?
Well, they show the remarkable fact that you have these amoebae that stream together, and then they produce a structure which has two cell types, stalk cells and terminal spores. So it's really quite a remarkable phenomenon.